Hello, today we'll be making a Pong game in Scratch. Let's get started. So first, let's paint the backdrop black. Just like that. There we go. Now we'll create a new sprite called Player 1. And we'll draw a long white rectangle. Okay. There we go. Now we'll duplicate player 1, and this will automatically create player 2. And then we'll draw another sprite named Ball. Now we're just gonna draw a white square. Okay, let's code. Go to player 1. When green flag is clicked, we're going to broadcast start. When we receive start, we're going to stop other scripts in this sprite, and we're going to position the player to X minus 190 and Y 0. And then we're going to repeat forever if key W is pressed. Then we'll change the Y position by 10. And then we'll duplicate the script and edit the key to S, and we're going to change Y by minus 10. Duplicate the script to player 2, and we're going to edit the keys to up and down arrows, and we're going to change the positions to 190. Okay, let's test it. Yes, both paddles work smoothly. Now we're going to be creating two variables called player 1 score and player 2 score. Now let's go to player 1, and when green flag is clicked, before we broadcast start, we're going to set both variables to 0. Okay, let's go to ball and start coding. Okay, when we receive start, we're going to position the ball to XY00, and we're going to stop other scripts in this sprite before that. And now we'll point in a random direction between 1 and 360. Yeah, there we go. Okay, now we'll set the rotation style on this sprite to don't rotate. And repeat forever. Move 10 steps, and if touching edge, we're going to get a if else block. So if the X position is bigger than 200, which means the ball is on the far right side of the stage, you're going to change player 1 score by 1, and we're going to broadcast start and stop the script. Now let's duplicate the script. We're gonna make the condition: if X position is smaller than minus 200, we're going to change player 2 score by 1. Okay, so if else, then we're going to point in direction 180 minus direction. Okay, now finally we're going to if touching player 1 or player 2, we have to bounce, so we're going to point in direction 0 minus direction. Okay, now let's wait for a second when the game starts. Okay, there we go. And now let's show both variables and double click them and position them. And there we go. We've made a nice Pong game in Scratch. There are multiple ways you can improve this on your own, so keep experimenting. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.